to Vancouver, go on. So today is Easter Monday, and it is a public holiday in Jamaica, and it is also lockdown day number two. So it is all island-wide lockdown. So we can't go nowhere. We have to stay in our house and look through the window. Anyway, I am gonna make bread pudding my style. In fact, it is not even my style. It is the old-fashioned way of making bread pudding in Jamaica. You don't know. Yeah, man. So, not many people make bread pudding like this anymore. Them just stir up the bread, but you know, back in the days, them used to grate the bread and use the crumbs. So I'm using 10 slices of bread. I am tearing the bread slices into medium pieces and then putting them into a food processor. You don't have to put them into a food processor if you don't want to. Back in the days, my grandmother used to put the bread in the sun to get hard, and then she would grate it. The food processor is mincing the bread or grating the bread, whatever you want to call it, into crumbs. I'm putting the bread crumbs into a container and then set it aside. Now into another container, I have 2 cups of cow's milk. You can use evaporated milk if you want. And then I added 1/2 cup of white sugar, but the cup is not really full to the brim. And then to that, I am gonna add 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Give it a good stir to blend everything together, the vanilla, the sugar, and the milk. Now you can taste it if you want to see if it needs more sugar. Mine is okay because I don't want the bread pudding to be too sweet, you know? Yeah, man. I am using 1/2 teaspoon of overproof white rum, and if you have brandy, you can put 1/2 teaspoon of brandy as well. I don't have brandy right now, but when the brandy and the rum mix together in the bread pudding, it gives it a kick. 1 teaspoon of mixed spice and then 2 eggs beaten. If you do not want to use eggs, you can use 4 tablespoons of vegetable oil. It might not taste as if you use eggs, though, I'm telling you. Anyway, I am also adding 1 tablespoon of melted chiffon. Chiffon is margarine. You can use butter if you want. And then give it a good stir to combine everything. So now I am adding the blueberries, about 1/4 cup. The blueberries are washed. So after adding the blueberries, now I am gonna combine the bread crumbs with the milk mixture. So now I'm pouring the mixture into a greased loaf pan, and I am gonna bake in a preheated oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for about 55 minutes to 60 minutes. You can start checking it at the 50-minute mark, because sometimes it takes less than an hour to bake. I remove the bread pudding from the oven and allow it to cool, and this is what it looks like. This is how I love my bread pudding. If you like my method of preparing the bread pudding, you can try it for yourself. The bread pudding is moist and the blueberries brings out a nice refreshing taste, fruity taste. It is really nice. Yeah man, thanks for watching. What would until next time.